I was wondering about the role of time in this story, because I can see the ideology behind it, and overcoming capitalism with new technologies is probably the only opportunity, and it would be great, of course.
Yeah.
But still, technology is always way, way faster than the society is, and all the ideas you have now would mean years and decades of change. And what will happen? We still live in this capitalist world.
Yeah.
What will happen in the meantime with all the unemployed people, for example?
Yeah.
My colleague was asking about before. And during this, how can this small group that is working on this idea now implement this change in the whole world?
Yeah.
And without all the problems with the generations in between?
Okay, this is a great area for research to start with. To share with you what we are thinking and what we are already doing. What we are using is how the people of today are trained. So we have this thought of we need 100,000 crazy people to build ecosystems like this. And what we are going to do is to make life radical cheaper. And that's a nice thing, because the other 7.6 billion people are trained on liking cheaper solutions. That's why we really want the human factor to be big in those solutions, because they will then step in because it's cheaper, but they will notice that it is actually better. One of the other teams we're working on, they are working on food challenge. It's a guy called Jurien Rosien, and he is the guy that, with his company, brought quinoa to the supermarkets. And he's now working on this new grain, Fonio. If you look it up, it's the healthiest grain you didn't know. And why is this? Because it grows in Chad. And as soon as the French colonists came in, they replaced the Fonio with a European wheat, which has a much looser root structure, which made the fruitful fields of Fonio turn into deserts. What he now is bringing back is, okay, can we create a food chain as a commons? And he's doing that in Chad. Chad is a very poor country, so there are almost no NGOs. And people have this understanding that they have to help each other to survive. So it's a starting point for cooperation there. But let's build a commons is something which is very researchable. If you then go to our world today, then we have a lot of people who are intrinsically motivated to have healthy food. They don't want to be a corporate who owns it. But food is the stuff that we put in our body. And in the world of today, you have these supermarkets that go to the people who deliver the food. And they say, well, we like what you're doing, but we want you to deliver the food at 25% lower cost next year, or else you're out. And the only thing the delivery people can do is to lower the quality. And then we have cheaper food. But that is the stuff we put into our bodies. So one of the things that Jurien is going to use is the way we are intrinsically motivated, the vast amount of people who are intrinsically motivated to have healthier food. And that means that he can crowdsource, he can discuss with the people, so that in a kind of wisdom of the crowd solutions, you get the best ideas up. Because that is a very large community, so a new social entity, that will be driven to create healthy food at lower prices or even at no cost. Because the community is not about making money out of food. The community is about creating healthy food. And this, these are new concepts. So this is why I like a lot to be here. Because there's a lot of research to be done to understand, okay, how does it work? What does it do and what doesn't it do? And there is some research on commons. the only woman who got the Nobel Prize in Economics, Ellen Ostrom, now I know her name again, she worked on commonses. She researched it for years and years and years. But there's also the law of Ostrom, and I don't have it wordly, but it is an ecosystem that works in praxis should also be able to work in theory. Because she had so much discussions with the people around her that there was a scientific discussion, this cannot be. And she was, but it works, it is here, you can see it, you can touch it. Yeah, but on a scientific perspective, this cannot be because we have this theory and this theory and this theory. So if you feel some energy to work on those questions, we need you.